So PFAS are per- and polyfluoroalkyl substances. These chemicals have been around for a long time. We've been using them since the 1950s. Many people in my field of environmental engineering have also been working on them for a long time, I'd say the last 10 to 15 years. The Seagrant had a specific call wanting to focus on emerging contaminants, specifically on PFAS. Around the time that call came out, that was when we were learning about a lot of the contamination in Marinette. This is kind of, you know, ground zero in Wisconsin for PFAS contamination. Sort of seeing that, knowing that the contamination was there, and knowing that this could potentially influence the Great Lakes, this seemed like a really good fit for something to work on. When we're talking about PFAS, we're talking about over 5,000 compounds. We don't actually know how many there are. Because they have these properties of repelling like both water and grease, they're used in a lot of things like for making Teflon, like your nonstick coatings on pans.
Teflon is made using PFOA. We use that in our raincoats, in our nonstick pans. It's in so many consumer products.
They're also used a lot in firefighting foams that are used, you know, at airports and by the military, and that's also a really major source of release to the environment. There are documented health effects in both animals and in people. You know, a whole range of things like thyroid function, increased cholesterol, up to cancer in some cases. So our Seagrant project is focusing up in the Marinette and Peshtigo area.
If that's the Green Bay, Marinette is right on the border here.
We found out around 2018 that there was extensive groundwater contamination near Marinette due to activities at the Tyco Fire Products facility. So we knew sort of going into this project that there was a lot of groundwater contamination, and we want to see what the impacts of this is on surface waters. So rivers in the area.
This borderline here can also double as the Menominee. That's one body of water that the DNR has found PFAS in. Another one is the Peshtigo River, and a lot of these sites go through neighborhoods and areas that don't seem like they would be very industrial.
Then we want to move a little bit bigger out, looking at Green Bay itself and Lake Michigan.
There are different ways that specifically synthetic chemicals can break down in the environment.
So this is PFOS. It goes on forever.
It can be a couple of days or a couple of years, but these compounds, we don't know that they break down at all.
This is like this carbon fluorine backbone of the chemical. It has all these carbon fluorine bonds that are really, really difficult to break down.
When we were up sampling in the fall, you know, it was a Sunday and we encountered a lot of people in the area just out raking their leaves. But everybody came up to us and they said, "Oh, are you looking for PFAS?" You know, they were all happy to help. Some people offered to go get samples for us. It's obviously out of concern, you know. They want to make sure their water resource is protected.
Well, I mean, the science really drives our ability to measure these chemicals in the first place and our ability to understand where they're going to end up in the environment and ultimately how to come up with better water treatment processes to remove them. I mean, I've gotten, like I said, calls a lot from reporters, but also, you know, my daughter's teacher at school is concerned, asking me questions about it, and people are concerned about it, and so we can use science to answer a lot of questions.
Any kind of regulation requires scientific data behind it to support that regulation.
You know, at the state level, there's a lot of really proactive efforts now and recognition that this is a big issue, and, you know, so there are regulations that are going to be coming out for water. There's a lot of initiatives in place for dealing with this, and I think what gives me hope is just the, yeah, people are aware of it and know it's an issue, and there's just a lot of movement on it right now.
It's something that people care about, and I feel good about doing something that is potentially going to make a difference to people's health.